I want to thank everybody for joining us this morning for this critical press conference. I am State Representative Morgan Cephas. I have the distinct pleasure of representing the 192nd Legislative District in West Philadelphia. Before we get started, I want to thank the activists. I want to thank our governor. I want to thank our Attorney General, Josh Shapiro. And I want to thank my colleagues for answering the call today and understanding the urgency of now, because women and birthing people's lives are on the line as we speak. Thank you for showing up in droves today. This past Friday, we watched a small group of extremist judges determine the reproductive rights. We are devastated. And we recognize there will be dark days ahead of us, but we have to remember we cannot be weary in our well-doing. We know millions of women and birthing people went to bed Thursday night only to find that next morning they were stripped of their rights, stripped of their ability to have autonomy over their bodies, forced to give birth regardless of the circumstance, forced now to be second-class citizens in this country. But in Pennsylvania, where abortion is still safe and legal, we want you all to know that we are still here for you, that this is a safe space, that this is a safe state for you to come and access a legal and a safe abortion. But we also know this, that just simply banning abortions only means you're banning legal and safe abortions. The ban on legal abortions will only return us to days where women, girls, and birthing people are criminalized and thrown in jail. Doctors will be stripped of their licenses. Individuals will be getting life-threatening abortions in back alleys. We know that banning abortions means the creation of reproductive refugees traveling from state to state. And it's not too far off. States like Ohio and West Virginia will now be flooding the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. We know these families. In preparation for this decision, we saw and heard women and birthing people come forward to share their individual stories about why this healthcare option is so critical. We saw the young hourly wage worker in Texas explain how she did everything right with contraceptives but still got pregnant. We know that middle-aged lawyer who's married but still talks about now needing to be careful because she doesn't want her career derailed by an unexpected pregnancy. Because while abortion was ruled by Roe v. Wade, we also know in this country there is still no paid sick leave, no affordable child care, no pay equity. She understands that there's a formula shortage, a rising cost of food, gas, and transportation. She knows, like we all know, this isn't just a healthcare issue, it's an economic issue. And it will be an economic issue for those that are the most marginalized in our communities. Or we all know that young woman that I constantly talk about when I'm talking about maternal mortality, where she lost her life while giving birth to her baby girl. Because we know this country does not protect or have the system where women, particularly black women, are able to stay alive during pregnancy. There is a person that dies every single day due to a pregnancy complication, so this ruling is literally a matter of life and death. Sadly to say, all the things I talked about, this is a new reality for so many families in states like Alabama, Missouri, Arkansas, and we know more than 20 other states with trigger laws to ban abortion or pass laws to increase restrictions will only come into effect very soon. So Pennsylvania now has a task to do. We now have to be prepared for an influx of patients coming to seek abortion access here in the Commonwealth. But we already know we have a system that is extremely overburdened. We know that Planned Parenthood clinics went from having over 50 clinics in this Commonwealth of Pennsylvania down to 17 clinics. We know that individuals literally today cannot access abortion care, that they had to travel miles, that they had to travel hours in order to access this option. We know that is our reality today. So imagine what is at stake when we have extremist judges, but also Republicans that are in our backyard, ready with bills in the House, ready with a constitutional amendment in the Senate. One vote away where they do not need the governor's veto pen. They can take it straight to the ballot with the expectation that in May 2023, this is something that we will be faced here in Pennsylvania. We are one vote away to where we could be like Texas, Ohio, Arkansas. So this isn't just a rally, this is a call to action. We have to do more than just stand here with our signs. We have to do more than just talking to one another. We have to fight like hell and act on every single level to shore up this system in Pennsylvania so we are not only protecting, but we are expanding access to safe abortions. And it's not just for the people in this room today, for the women, the birthing people, and the families across our Commonwealth. We have to do this for our daughters, our grandchildren, and the girls of tomorrow, because we know that this is a life or death situation, and we have to act now here in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.